Good morning and welcome to the Daily Download. I'm your host, Dr. Darrar Pulley. This is the day the Lord has made. We are rejoicing and we are glad in it. Happy Tuesday, everyone. We welcome you to the Daily Download where the Lord daily loads us with his benefits. And I'm telling you, today is already loaded. It is already jammed and packed with the lessons and blessings of God. And my heart and my mind are open to receive all the good that God has for me. And I am praying with you today that your heart and your mind are open and receptive to divine unlimited ideas. If this is your first time watching the Daily Download, like, follow, and share the Dr. Darrar Pulley page so that you can get notifications of when we are on Facebook Live. And if you're one of our regular Kingdom citizens, students of truth, you know what time it is. It is time to invite a family member, a friend, a neighbor, a co-worker, a classmate, a church member, and let them know that you're looking at the Daily Download Live with Dr. Darrar Pulley and invite them to watch it live with you. Well, we're talking about the impact of the Israel experience. And I'm telling you, it was a life-changing experience to be in the Holy Land. And my life will never be the same again. I have been transformed by the renewing of my mind, and my life will never be the same again. And I'm telling you, today is an opportunity for your life to be transformed and for you to never be the same again. So today, I'm talking about the impact of being at the tomb of Mary. The second most impactful experience that I had in the Holy Land. Yesterday, we talked about the Beatitudes and the mountain of Beatitudes. The second most powerful, most impactful experience I had was being at the tomb of Mary. Of Mary, Mary the mother of Jesus. And so Mary was a very significant figure in the life of Jesus. Of course, she was his mother. Before Jesus took on this full physical form, he was an idea that was inside of her. She was pregnant with this possibility. She was pregnant with Jesus. And so Mary was the mother of Jesus. Mary was there, of course, as his mother for his early development. We see Mary and Jesus at 12 years old, where Jesus, you know, left them and they had to find him and all of that. So they find him in the temple. So she's there in his early life. Mary is there at the beginning of his ministry when he performs his first miracle, the marriage at Cana, the wedding at Cana. Mary was the one that kind of encouraged him and pushed him to says, this is your time, this is your season to go forth in the miracles that God has called you to perform. Even in his ministry, there were periodic times when Mary came to kind of interact and check on her son and see how it was doing. And Jesus said, behold, my father, my mother, my sister, and my brother are those that do the will of God. And so Mary was also at the cross, at the foot of the cross when Jesus was crucified. And so Mary also was there at the resurrection. Who are the Marys in your life? Who are the people that are there with you through your process, through the development of the Christ consciousness in you? Who are the Marys in your life? Who are the people that are there helping you each and every step of the way? Mary was a figure that kind of like a thread that went out through the life of Jesus. And God sends Marys in our lives to be with us through our spiritual unfolding. Mary represents that wonderful preciousness of unfolding in the presence of God. And so therefore, we are looking at Mary and the experience I had of being at the tomb of Mary. Pulley point number one, what made this such a powerful experience is that the tomb of Mary is only open 2 days a week. Monday from 10 to 12, and Tuesdays from 10 to 12. That's the only time that the tomb of Mary is open. And in the holy place, wherever these spiritual relics are, they build churches, they build temples there in honor of these spiritual holy places. And so this church is only open Mondays and Tuesdays from 10 to 12. I was leaving another place, and in an unexpected small exchange and dialogue, it was just recommended to us to go to the tomb of Mary, which was down the street from another site. And so we went there, it was raining, we went to the tomb of Mary, and we went there, and because of the days, because it was a rare occasion, there weren't a lot of people there. You know, because it wasn't advertised, you know, people didn't really know what the hours were, what the times were. So a lot of people weren't there. People weren't fighting over the space, fighting to take pictures. It was really a sacred moment. People didn't want because of the day. The day and the days that we have this actual site open. And so I'm saying to you, to open up your mind that each and every day of your life can be a day of the unexpected. Follow the divine order and flow of God in your life so that you can have a day today that was not even expected. This is the day. The Lord daily loads us with benefits. He give us this day our daily bread. So we open our hearts and our minds today to unexpected things to happen today. Now unto him who is able to do exceeding abundantly above all that you could ask or even think, according to the power that works within you. I'm telling you, today is your day for a miracle. Today is your day to experience the power and the presence of God and new and unexpected ways. So pulley point number two, not only was it the day that made this such a powerful experience, is that we had to go down. Now, different from yesterday with the Mount of Beatitudes, where we had to ascend up, in going to the tomb of Mary, we had to go down. We had to go down into this tomb. We had to go down the steps. And so it was a quiet, sacred presence. And as I kept going down and kept going down and kept going down these steps to actually get to the tomb of Mary, I felt like I was going deeper and deeper in Christ consciousness. I felt like I was going deeper and deeper into the true essence of who I am as a child of God. So not only does God take us higher, God also takes us deeper. Be open to the depth of your experience with God. And so as I was going through down those steps, and I'm telling you, those steps were very steep. As I was going through and down those steps, I began to go deeper and deeper into my Christ consciousness, deeper into the fact that I am a child of God, made in the image and likeness of God. I began to go deeper into the truth of who I really am. And so it was in that depth that I began to have a spiritual experience. Because I went deeper. Those steps represented me going deeper into the essence. It's time for you to get rid of the shallow, to get rid of the surface, and go deeper into who you truly are. Through prayer, through meditation, through worship, it's time to go deeper into who you really are. Pulley point number three. Not only was it today, not only was it going down the steps, but when I was open to what could happen that day, and when I went to the deeper with the steps, when I went down the steps, pulley point number three, is I felt a depth of the presence. Now, there were some places that I expected to feel an overwhelming sense of the presence of God, and I didn't feel it. But in a place that was not even on the map, a place that was not advertised and not scheduled, I felt a depth of the presence of God. I had time to be able to be there and process without people pushing and shoving. And, you know, it was just, I was able to commit. And it was such a presence of God. and God is the everywhere evenly present spirit of absolute good. But I became aware of the presence of God, and I felt a deep sense of the presence of God at the tomb of Mary, so much so that I had to get on my knees and begin to pray, because that's the depth of the presence of God that I felt. Y'all remember that song? When I feel the Spirit moving in my heart, I pray. Whenever you are and you feel that depth of the presence of God, pray right where you are. Take that moment to commune with Spirit right where you are whenever you feel that presence of God. All right, let's review. So pulley point number one is that what made the tomb of Mary such a powerful, impactful experience is the day that I was open to something unexpected that day, and it was a rarity that that tomb was even open that day. Pulley point number two, the reason why this was such a powerful spiritual experience at the tomb of Mary is because I had to go down the steps, which represent going deeper into the essence of who I am. And pulley point number three, the reason why the tomb of Mary was such a powerful spiritual experience for me is because I went into a depth of the presence of God, and I prayed right there in that feeling of the depth of the presence of God. I love you so much. Thank you so much for being a part of the Daily Download. Remember to share this on your page with somebody today. You can experience the pictures and the videos of what it was like to be in the tomb of Mary. And thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for your investments that you've made in the Israel experience, you know, for sowing a seed, for meeting a need in the Daily Download. Remember to share this on your page. If you're looking for a shorter version of today's message, you can find that on Instagram or Twitter. You can also see previous messages on our YouTube channel. Subscribe to that as well. Until tomorrow morning at 6:30 a.m., remember that all the glory belongs to God. And therefore we say Yahweh, which is a Hebrew way to say God, a Hebrew way to say Jehovah, that we go deeper into the presence of God.